What the heck is a Facebook Pixel? What does it do? How does it even work? Is this just some mysterious thing that just helps me track my stuff? In this video, I'm going to be teaching you exactly what the Facebook Pixel is, what it does, how it works. This is going to be a super, super, super simple demonstration just so that you can understand conceptually what it is and how you can use it to benefit you and your marketing. And that's coming up right now. What's going on, guys? Gabe Kemsey here with GabeyKemsey.com. I am your internet marketing guide. On my channel, I teach internet marketing and entrepreneurship. So if this is your first time on my channel, go ahead and subscribe, hit the notification button so you can get updates on new videos that I release every week. Now, this video, I'm going to be explaining exactly what the Facebook Pixel is. Now, if you want to learn how you can actually create and set up your Facebook Pixel, a very beginner's guide, you can do so. Click that link there to go to that video, or it'll be in the description below. Or if you want some more advanced stuff and you want to learn how to create custom events or custom conversions and how to set all that stuff up, you can click that video up there or click down in the description below. Now, this video particularly is going to be very super helpful, especially if you're a beginner. So let's go ahead and dive into this. I'm going to make this super simple to understand. So let's go over to this presentation that I created just for this. So what is the Facebook Pixel? So this is a super simple explanation of what the heck a Facebook Pixel is, how it works, and why I should even care, or why you should care, okay? So first of all, let's dive into what a pixel actually is. Now, if you've watched the movie Pixels, then you might have an idea, but to give you a firm definition, a pixel is the smallest unit of a digital image or graphic that can be displayed and represented on a digital display device. So in layman's terms, basically a pixel is the smallest component of an image. So think of it in terms of like atoms. I'm gonna throw some physics at you here, right? So atoms are literally the smallest element in matter, right? So in the sense of pictures and images, all images and pictures are boiled down to what are called pixels. So let me display this for you here. So imagine this blue square is just an image, right? So if we were to pixelate this blue image, it'll just be made of a bunch of different pixels, okay? And then one of those tiny dots represents one pixel. So that in itself is what your Facebook Pixel is. It is legitimately one tiny pixel of an image that you and I can't see through the human eye. Like, it's literally so tiny, you can't see it. However, the computer and, you know, the internet, desktop, whatever services that you're using, including Facebook, they can read it because of the code. You know, they read it through the code. They don't actually have to see it physically, unlike me and you would have to, okay? So imagine when you're setting up your Facebook Pixel and you're installing your Facebook Pixel on your website or on ClickFunnels or on a landing page or on your affiliate site, what you're basically doing is you're taking a tiny, minute dot that you can't see and you're sticking it on that page. Basically, and whenever that page loads up, whenever it's brought up either by you or by somebody else who stumbles upon it or clicks on it, although me and you can't actually see the pixel on that page, the computer reads it as, hey, there's a pixel on this page because of through the code. And depending on what you set that pixel to display as is going to depend on what Facebook is going to tell you what event is going on. So that might still sound a little confusing, so let me break this down a little bit further, okay? Let's say, for example, you have my site, right? This is just a screenshot of my website. I want to set up my Facebook Pixel on my website. Now, if you watched my Create a Facebook Pixel video, I recommend setting your Facebook Pixel up in every way, shape, and every way possible, right? You want to set it up in all your sites, all your whatever, set it up, you know, because you never know what this traffic and the data that you gather, how it can help you and how you can use it later on in the future. So let's take my site, for example, and I want to track views, right? I want to track how many people on a daily basis are taking a look at my website. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a pixel, the Facebook Pixel specifically, and I'm going to put it on my site, right? I'm going to place it on my site. Now, this is a big image. I you know, the red dot symbolizes a pixel. Obviously, it's not that big, otherwise all websites would just have dots all over them and that would be super annoying. But just imagine that this pixel is so small that me and you can't see it in the human eye, but the computer can read it because of the code. So whenever this page loads, whenever my homepage loads with this pixel that's attached to it, this red pixel, it's gonna read as one view. right? Because we have this pixel set as, hey, whenever somebody loads this page up, I want you to tell me that that is one view, okay? So another example is, what if we wanted to check leads, okay? What if I wanted to track the leads? Maybe I'm running a campaign or, you know, whatever, and I wanted to track leads. The same thing, we have one pixel. Now remember, in your Facebook ad account, everybody has one pixel, but your one pixel can track different events. It can track different conversions, okay? So the same pixel that I use to track views, I can use to track leads. And so all I gotta do is put my pixel on my website, a pixel that I can't see, but the computer can see. And so whenever a certain page loads, it's gonna load as one lead. It's gonna say, hey, this page was just loaded. So now on Facebook's end, it's gonna say, because I see this green pixel on this page, I'm gonna say that you just got one lead because that's the conversion or event that you got set up, okay? So I hope that makes sense right there. That's basically what a pixel is doing. It's tagging different sites, different pages, whatever you put your pixel on, so that whenever that page loads, Facebook translates it and reads it as, hey, this event happened. And that event is whatever you set it to be, okay? So another example here is, let's say I wanted to track multiple things. Let's say for a particular page, it might not be the same page, but this is the page I have right here for an example. Let's say I wanted to say, anytime this page loads, I want to track lead. I want it to track and register as a lead and as a view. So remember, we still have one pixel, but one pixel, when we put that on that site, and we have the different conversion or the different event, it's going to read as, this pixel is tracking one lead and one view when this page loads up. Okay, guys, so it's the same premise. It's all about this pixel being on whatever page you want it to be. And whatever you define that pixel as being is what it's going to translate and what information it's going to give Facebook whenever that page loads. So what is the key to defining the event, defining the conversion? How do you tell the pixel, hey, whenever this page loads, I want you to tell me it's a lead, or I want you to tell me it's a view, or I want you to tell me it's a sale, or any of the conversion events that Facebook offers, okay? The key is your URL here, highlighted in yellow. That's the key, and that's where creating the rules come in, because like I said, me and you can't physically see the pixel, but the computer reads the pixel through the code. So through the URL, you can tell the computer or Facebook, hey, whenever a certain element in my URL shows up, that is what I want you to define the pixel as, okay? So this is a screenshot of what it looks like in your pixels, in your pixel section in your ads manager when you're setting up your custom conversions, right? See where it says create custom conversions? Now, this is exactly what I'm talking about. So let's say for this previous example where I wanted to set this picture up or set up my homepage and I want it to read, for example, leads, okay? So what I do is the rule number one, this is my rule, the website event, is the URL contains what? So what you want to do is you want to add a keyword that is within that specific URL, okay? Not in any other URLs because that's going to get confusing, but in that specific URL. So you're basically saying whenever I load a page up, whenever I load this page up and it has some indication in the URL, right, then I want the pixel to say this. So whenever you add a keyword or whatever to your URL, then you can name your conversion. So you can name it like lead conversion or whatever. The category you can choose, you can pick from lead, you can lead to views, to add to cart, to purchase. There's a bunch of different categories that you can look at, and then you can assign a value to it, whether you're making a sale or whatnot. Now, if you want more of a tutorial that shows you exactly how to set this up and how to get this all situated, then go ahead and click that video that I mentioned above earlier, the little bit more advanced video for how to set up custom conversions and events, okay? But this is just a screenshot just to show you that the power of the pixel comes from your URL. So let's do some examples here, right? So how the Facebook pixel actually works. When a page loads and it has a Facebook pixel on it, Facebook will register that activity as an event, Okay, so you remember how I was telling you the power and how what your pixel tells you is going on is based on your URL? So let's say my URL is my website here, Gabe Ekemezi, okay? So the rule is it contains Gabe Ekemezi. Whenever a page loads up and it contains this, the event, the pixel is gonna say it's a view, okay? So my URL here is Gabe Ekemezi. So the rule is whenever any page where my Facebook pixel is installed, whenever any page that loads that has the keywords Gabe Ekemezi in it, I want you to tell me it's a view, right? So you're telling me anytime this page loads, somebody's looking at my site, and I want you to tell me that there's a view, okay? So let's take the same URL, right? But now I've added a buy, right? Maybe I created another page on my website, and after somebody buys a product or something like that, right, this is my URL. So my rule is going to be, the rule contains the word buy, just like it contains the word buy here. So whenever a page loads and it contains this URL or the word buy, now you can use either one word or you can use the whole URL. I could have said the rule contains www.gabeekemezi.com/buy. I could have used the whole thing, but I'm just giving an example here. Whatever this keyword is, the pixel registers that as a sale. So anytime this page loads up, if somebody were to click this page or if someone were to go to this page via buying something and they end up on this URL, if my pixel is on this URL and this rule is created, then on Facebook, it's going to tell me, hey, it's a sale, and it's going to register as a sale. Next example, right? If I have another URL, but I have a ebook at the end of it, right? The rule contains the word ebook, okay? So that's the rule. So anytime the page loads and this ebook is within the URL, I want the pixel to read as a lead. So that means, and like the reason I use the example is because I have let's say I'm trying to build up my email list and I want to get more leads. So I hand out a free ebook, which I actually have a free ebook that I give to people. But whenever people come to this website and my pixel is installed on that website, the rule is whenever that loads, the computer is going to see ebook. And with the pixel and the ebook there, it's going to read that event as a lead. Okay, so hopefully that makes a little bit of sense there, guys. So just a little bit of a diagram just to drive this point home. We're going to do like a lead generation example, right? So like I just said earlier with the lead generation example for like my ebook, what you want to do is you want to place your Facebook pixel on conversion points, right? Basically on the websites or the pages where in order for somebody to land on that page, they had to have done something. And you know they had to have done something, and that's why it's going to register an event as that. So to explain that, let's say we take this lead generation example. I have my capture page, right? Now, I want my Facebook pixel to track leads, okay? And the only way somebody can become a lead is if they put their name and email in here, and once they press enter, then they're gonna be brought to a thank you page, right? And if they see that thank you page, first, for example, if you put in your information and you see that thank you page, you are now my lead, right? So now that's how I want to define my Facebook pixel. So in order to get to this thank you page, you have to put in your information, right? And you can't get to this thank you page without that, okay? So my rule for my pixel is I'm gonna put my pixel on this page, and I'm gonna make the rule whatever this URL is. See, the URL contains www.example.com/thank you. Just pretend that's the URL for this page. So whenever you put this pixel on your thank you page and this page loads, remember it loads because somebody put their information here in the first place. So now that it's loaded, Facebook is going to track that as, hey, you just got one lead, right? Why did I just get one lead? Because this page loaded, I have the pixel on this page, I defined the rule that whenever this page with the URL loads, I want the event to be a lead. And the only way that you can actually get to this page is if you actually become a lead and give me your name and email address, right? And then from there, they can go to a webinar, or they can go into your email list, whatever you want to do. But this is the conversion point, right? So that's where you want to place your Facebook pixel. So when you're when you're installing your Facebook Pixel, you want to install it on this particular page. Or if you're installing it, like let's say in ClickFunnels, you want to install your lead conversion on your thank you page, right? This could have view or whatever else, but you want this to be your lead, okay? So I hope that makes sense. Let's take another example for all my e-commerce people out there, right? Same premise, okay? Let's say you have your store, and then when people like something in your store, they go to your shopping cart, and then from there, they go to a sale. So now we can have multiple conversion events here based off of what people do and what pages load up. So in order for somebody to get to the shopping cart, they have to click on a product and say add to shopping cart, right? So once they're in the shopping cart, the URL for this is example.com/shopping cart. This page loads. I have a pixel on this page that says whenever this page loads based on this URL, this is our rule, I want you to tell me it's an add to cart, right? Because that's what it is. Somebody clicked on a product here, they added it to the shopping cart, this page loads. The rule for this page says whenever this page loads with this URL contains rule, I want you to tell me it's an add to cart. Okay, so that's how the Facebook Pixel works for different conversions, different events. Let's say they added it to cart and then they actually buy. Now they go to the sales page, and it could be a thank you page, like, hey, thank you for purchasing, download your product here, or this, or you know, you do shipping or whatever you're doing, but they go to a thank you page where you get the sale. So when this page loads, right, the URL contains this www.zomba.com/buy, you know, this is the rule for whenever this page loads. And when this page loads with your pixel on it, I want you to record it as a sale or as a purchase. So this is how Facebook is getting data. So whenever you're going into your ads manager and you're looking and you're seeing all that data coming in from your pixel, that pixel information is coming from two things. One, where you install your pixel. This is why I say you should install your pixel everywhere, right? And two, what rule you have based off of where you installed it. So those are the two things. And so to create custom events or custom conversions and create that rule, that's what you do when you're creating a custom conversion. Like I said earlier, if you want to see exactly how to do that on Facebook, check out my more advanced pixel video training there. Okay, guys? But that is it, guys. That is what the Facebook Pixel is and how it works exactly. So I hope this video was helpful for you. I hope it gives you a little bit more of an understanding of what the Facebook Pixel is, how it works. So now when you're going on to creating your Facebook Pixels or you're creating your custom events or custom conversions, now I get it. Now you kind of understand why installing the Facebook Pixel on a particular page works, why setting up the rules work in a certain way, and how the pixel to me and you is invisible because we don't actually see physical dots, but they're actually in reality there when we put them on different pages because we put them through the code and the computer and the internet and stuff reads that code and translates that code into the different events based off of the rules that we give them. So like this video, guys. Share this video with anybody that you think would get value from this, whether they are in Facebook advertising or an agency, want to get into this stuff and understand exactly what the pixel is. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you have not yet already done so. And if you would like to download my free 10 Facebook ads copy cheat sheet where I go over 10 secrets to creating effective ads that work and that convert, then you can download that down in the description below as well. I appreciate you guys so much for watching, and I will catch you guys on the next video.